Minister Matia Kasaija affirms that as government, they will ensure strict accountability of any shilling that is being spent in this new program, and the beneficiaries must produce what they have agreed on.
There's going to be strict accountability of every shilling that one has got. If you don't produce what you agreed upon, the next thing you know what will happen.
He explains that the other programs, including Emyoga and Youth Livelihood Program, were selective in nature, but this one targets everyone at parish level. The only challenge anticipated is on enterprise selection.
When I do this with the technical officer, the agriculture officers, and whatnot, the production officers, we help the people, the ordinary people under the on the parish, to find out what is the right enterprise that they can do that does first of very well and that makes money. Everything that they do, they must make money. So the next thing then will be the marketing. The marketing we shall handle. We either will have to add through either value addition or export or taking whatever to other cities who may be wanting to have that particular product that is being produced, which may be not being produced everywhere.
The target is to have each household earn 20 million shillings every year.
Particularly in this area, there is a problem of fatalism. That's the change, mind change. I said really the first thing they must tackle is fatalism. That is not possible, it cannot work, that is for you who are educated. No, it is not educated alone. As long as you have strength in your body and you can work, you can get out of poverty.
Andrew Byakutaga, the Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom Prime Minister, is optimistic about the program. Others, though, express worry that the parish development model may face similar challenges like many other programs if the government does not stop corrupt officials.
I request that since the government has played its role of bringing the program to the grassroots, we need and we request those people who are going to be participants in the program, let them be committed.
The religious leaders you see here are willing to support this program with all our vigor, because even it talks of, it aims at developing our people, developing our communities. When the communities are developed, the churches, the mosques are also developed.
The parish development model is a whole of government strategy or approach for organizing and delivering public and private sector interventions for wealth creation and employment generation at the parish as the lowest economic planning unit. It is centered on data collection, infrastructure development, delivery of social services, feedback on government services, area-based enterprise selection and development, cooperatives development, financial inclusion, community mobilization, as well as mindset change. This report was compiled by Ambrose Niwagaba for the news.